My name is Morgan Holmes, and I am a researcher with the Energy Policy Innovation Council, or EPIC, at Arizona State University. We provide unbiased research and information to policymakers and the community on energy policy best practices, with a special focus on Arizona and clean energy innovation. Today I'm going to talk about what your energy bill pays for. When we get our energy bills, like most other bills, the actual payment amount is broken out into a number of individual fees that combine to make up our monthly payment amount. I'm focusing here on the energy bills sent out by the larger utility companies in Arizona, including APS, Tucson Electric Power, or TEP, and the Salt River Project, or SRP. On the bills that come from any of these major electricity providers, the individual fees listed on the bill fall into a few major categories. The actual name of the fee may be slightly different depending on the provider, and some providers will combine certain charges into a single fee. But in general, the fee categories include delivery, generation, which can include power supply adjustments and transmission costs, taxes and assessments, green charges, logistical service, including metering and billing, and other, including low-income assistance, system benefits, and a Department of Transportation safety surcharge. First, we will talk about the delivery charge. The delivery charge is a charge based on kilowatt-hour usage and or kilowatt-hour demand to build and operate the equipment for delivering electricity to the home or business. This includes transmission lines, poles, transformers, and substations. APS calls this the delivery service charge, and SRP includes the delivery charge in its energy charge. Next, we'll talk about the service charge. The service charge generally covers the cost of keeping service available, whether or not it's used, the costs of billing and collections, and the costs of maintaining and reading the meter. APS breaks the service charge into several individual fees for the costs above, while SRP includes these costs in a monthly service charge. Next, we'll talk about generation charges. The generation charge typically covers the cost of producing or purchasing the electricity during both peak and non-peak hours. APS and SRP break this into separate charges for the generation of electricity on peak and off peak. TEP appears to cover this cost in their general usage charge. Next, we'll talk about taxes. In Arizona, the electricity bill will generally contain state, county, and city sales taxes. APS and TEP break out the taxes individually, while SRP combines the taxes into just two charges. TEP also breaks out a city public utility tax and a city franchise fee. APS also breaks out the franchise fee, which it notes is a charge by a municipality for APS's use of the public rights-of-way for its facilities. Next, we'll talk about assessments. Assessments are generally fees charged to support the operation of the Arizona Corporation Commission, or the ACC, and the Residential Utility Consumer Office, or RUCO. The ACC is the state commission responsible for regulating Arizona utilities and setting reasonable utilities rates. RUCO is an entity that was established by the state legislature in 1983 to represent residential ratepayers before the ACC in rate-related proceedings involving public service corporations. TEP also breaks out an assessment for the Arizona Independent Scheduling Administrator, or AZISA. This assessment is required by the ACC and helps to fund AZISA, which oversees the application of operating protocols to ensure statewide consistency for transmission access. APS combines both the ACC and the RUCO assessments into one fee, and TEP breaks out each assessment individually. Next, we'll talk about green charges. In some cases, the energy bill will also contain charges to help cover the costs of local energy efficiency programs or the costs of meeting federal environmental standards. Next, we'll talk about logistical service charges. A portion of the electric bill typically goes toward covering logistical costs, like the cost of servicing your meter and the cost of sending you your bill, if those costs have not already been included elsewhere in your fees. Finally, most bills will include a variety of additional charges to cover specific programs like assistance for low-income consumers, customer education, and the Department of Transportation safety surcharge. This is just a brief overview of some of the charges included in your energy bills, but you can typically find additional information on your specific bills by going to the individual utility websites. Thank you for watching.